Hello everyone, welcome to your English lesson with me, your charming, kind, and modest Gabrielle. That is an important part of our lesson today, how to describe people's character and personality. That was the problem in our sitcom, wasn't it? Victor and Agatha's personalities are too different, and that makes for a very difficult living situation. So, as well as describing personality, we will also review the future tense, using will, going to, and the present continuous and the present simple, and study the expression have to in the future. Oh, I'm giving a party next Saturday. It's Dylan's birthday. Are you going to come? Sure, you'll love it. Right, first let's review the future tenses. Do you remember when we use the verb to be plus going to? That's right. We use it to talk about future plans and intentions. Like when Agatha says, I'm going to stay with Betty. We also use it to talk about predictions based on what we can see at that moment. For example, saying, I think it's going to rain when you can see storm clouds. And when do we use will? We use it with offers. I will help you carry your bag. Promises. I won't come home late. Predictions without evidence. You'll love the film. And instant decisions. I'll have a ham sandwich. Now, to talk about the future, we also use the present continuous when we want to talk about future arrangements. For example, if I say, I'm meeting my friends tonight, I am talking about something that I have arranged to do. He's flying to Rome tomorrow. We're playing volleyball in the morning. We can also use the present simple for fixed future arrangements. I start my Spanish course next week. It begins at 9 o'clock. Wow, there are a lot of ways to talk about the future. Can you remember them all? Don't worry, you will. That's a promise. If we want to say that someone has to do something in the future, we use the expression will have to. For example, if you want to speak English well, you will have to study hard. If I want to buy a new car, I will have to save lots of money. Will have to stays the same in all persons. So we can also say, if Dylan wants me to cook dinner, he will have to wash the dishes. Okay, for his birthday, I'll do everything. Now, let's look at some ways that we can talk about character and personality. As I said before, I think I am charming, kind, and definitely modest. How about you? Are you timid and shy like Elena, or reserved like Victor? Or maybe you are like Agatha, sociable, loyal, and generous, but also stubborn, selfish, and demanding. My Dylan is such a sweet and caring man, but he can also be very moody at times. Lady Coco is loving and affectionate when she wants food, but she can be quite aggressive if I try to give her a bath. It's not easy being a mom. Speaking of which, I think it's bath time now for my little kitty cat. Wish me luck. See you next time.